Hey there guys, Paul here from theengineeringmindset.com. In this video, we're going to be looking at the four-port reversing valve, which is used in heat pumps. Now this is a critical component in the heat pump system, and this is what allows the refrigerant to reverse its flow, and that will provide both heating and cooling modes. So the reversing valve will look something like this, and you can see here we've got the main valve body there, and we've got four ports, and by ports it just means ports of entry or points of entry. So you've got one here, one here, one here, one here, equaling to four. Then we've got these capillary tubes which connect to each side of the main body valve and also onto a high and low pressure point within the pipes, and we'll have a look at how all this works shortly. And then over here we've got the solenoid coil with a sliding valve inside, which we'll look at also. So just to show you the back there as well, how all the pipes are connected. If I just remove some of the casing there so we can have a look inside, what you'll see is inside is this kind of seat here, and it's connected to this slider, and this will slide from side to side, and that allows the refrigerant to pass along and exit through here or through this side and vice versa. So this is what's going to make the main reversing point for there. And to achieve that and push this along, we've also got another sliding valve up here. And this allows, if you've got the high pressure coming in here from the compressor, and that as the refrigerant comes in, it can come in. Once this coil is energized, this has a magnetic field around it when an electronic current passes through it. And when that current is initiated, and that will pull this valve across, and that will make the high pressure refrigerant pass through here, all the way through this valve, and slide that over, allowing the refrigerant to move through. There is a little spring in here usually, so once that is de-energized and electricity is cut off, that valve would then be pushed automatically by default back to its setting over there, and that would allow the high pressure refrigerant to enter here and pass into here and obviously push against this side, sliding the valve body this way. The other capillary tubes, they're just going to take the pressure away, so as this valve moves across, obviously there's going to be some refrigerant in there, and the force of that needs to go somewhere, so it's going to push it back around, obviously, into here. So as it pushes this way, all that refrigerant that was in there would pass through this, back round through this tube, and into the low pressure line there. So we'll have a look now at how the valve works in a bit more detail. So as we've just seen, we've got the main valve body here, and then we've got the circuit running around here in a coil. And then passing away. You can see at the moment the circuit is broken, so there's no current passing through here, and that means that this spring here is pushing that valve body all the way across, meaning the refrigerant can flow to this side. And we've got the refrigerant coming in here straight from the compressor. Some of that will be drawn off and it will pass through here and hit into this solenoid coil at the side. You'll see the only flow option it's got is to pass through this way. And that will fill this chamber here, forcing this sliding valve body all the way across. When that slides across, that means the rest of that refrigerant that's coming in here will pass along and straight through and out. And as you can see from this one, this will create a loop here so that these two tubes can be passed along. And we'll see what these are connected to very shortly. Now, when the circuit is made here, or a controller makes it, it's going to create a magnetic field here when the current passes through there. That magnetic field pulls this valve body over, compressing that spring, and it pulls the valve body over. And that means that now the high pressure refrigerant coming in will siphon off here. You can see it can't go anywhere through this tube anymore, but there is an opening here. So it will fill this void here, and the refrigerant will then pass through this capillary tube all the way down and around to here. The refrigerant will keep coming because it's a high pressure, so that will force this piston all the way over, moving that valve body with that. And now you can see how the refrigerant would come in here from straight from the compressor, pass through here and exit, whereas the remaining refrigerant would cycle through a loop here. And obviously if you de-energize this circuit here, then the valve body would be pushed over to here again, and the refrigerant would then pass and move this valve body over again. It'll just keep cycling back and forth to match the heating or cooling mode as desired by the user. So let's just have a little look at how this will be connected up. You can see we've got the reversing valve here. Down in the corner, we've got the compressor, scroll compressor in this case. And over here, we've got the indoor unit. We've also got the outdoor unit. Then we've got the thermal expansion valves, and we've also got the check valves laying over here. Now this setup is just a very basic to help you understand. There are some slightly different methods to pipe this up, but this is purely for educational purposes to help you understand how this system works and why it's important. So you can see here when the heat pump is in the heating mode that the hot refrigerant is coming straight from the compressor. It's passing around, it comes down to the reversing valve. The seat is in the correct position at the moment, which means the refrigerant will be passed straight along and off into the indoor unit. So all that heat that was where it's been compressed, all that thermal energy will start to be dispersed here in the indoor unit. That will then leave, it will come to the check valve. Obviously it can't pass this way through the thermal expansion valve, TXV. So it can pass through the check valve, and it'll pass through here. Now we'll get to this check valve and realize that no, we can't pass through that way, but we can go through this thermal expansion valve. So it will, and it will bypass this valve here. It'll come in and then go into the, after it's been expanded, come into the outdoor unit, pass through the coil, etc., and then pass along through here and then up back into the reversing valve. That's why we've got the valve body there. So at the moment, this will then pass through there and straight back down into the compressor to complete the cycle. Now in the opposite mode, where it's now in cooling mode, so the refrigerant is still hot, it's coming out of the compressor, passing along down into the reversing valve again. The valve body has moved over, which means the refrigerant will pass along here and go straight to the outdoor unit. It will then cool down into a liquid and pass through here. You can see, again, it's going to come to the check valve, and it will pass through there because it can't pass through this way through the thermal expansion valve, in this case anyway. That will then come along, get to the next check valve, realize it can't pass through there. Divert and come through the thermal expansion valve, expand that, come through the indoor unit where it will absorb some of the heat within the building and provide that cool. Refrigerant will then continue its cycle along here back to the four-port reversing valve. This time it's entering through this port, passing across, please excuse me, I've put the graphic the wrong there, but that would pass along there, continue its route down and make its way back to the compressor. Now for a much more detailed video on how the heat pump works, I suggest you check out the channel and have a look at the video I've put up for how a heat pump works, for a much more detailed version of this, showing you the main components and also describing a much more detailed animation of what's happening inside there. We've also got a much more advanced version where we're showing all the temperatures and pressures, etc., the enthalpy and entropy around the systems as well. But that is it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed this and it's really helped you. Please don't forget to like, subscribe and share. If you have any comments, please leave them in the comment section below. I'll try to answer them as soon as possible. Also, don't forget to check out our website, theengineeringmindset.com. And once again, thank you very much for watching.